Hi, hello, good morning students, welcome back. Today we will see chapter 9 from civics. I think this is the last one, that is struggles for equality. So you can see the images wherein you have studied different chapters from chapter number 1 to chapter number 8. You have studied the various concepts related to equality only. It may be the chapters related to Ansari, Kantabai, or it may be related to Sapna. One or the other way, they were, or you can say, treated unequally by the society. So, entire chapter of this civics series from chapter number 1 to chapter number 8 is related to equality. And today, that is the last chapter, that is chapter number 9, the struggle for equality, and we will sum up this civics chapter with this concept. Now let's see what we have studied in our previous chapters. We have studied in our previous chapters that people like Kanta, Ansaris and Sapna faced inequality by the people surround them. So they were not treated unequally by any third person. The people surround them, only they treated unequally or inequally. What do people do when they face such inequality? Then, history is full of examples of persons who have come together to fight against such inequality. Whenever there is inequality, people have come up to get their equality back. The Indian Constitution states that all are equal and that no person can be discriminated against because of their religion. Poverty and the lack of resources continue to be a key reason why so many people's lives in India are highly unequal. If we have to underline, then because of two reasons. One is poverty and second one is lack of resources. Resources, we have what is called resources. Hamare paas resource ka itni kami hai aur uske chalte people are discriminated or not treated equally. Now the chapter or the concepts, that is exactly main concept, that is the struggles for equality. Let's see. Throughout the world, in every community or village or city or town, we will find that there are some people and who are known and respected because of their fight or equality. If we see the history, then we will come across that there are many people, they are respected because of their fight for equality. These people may stood up against the act of discrimination that they faced, on which they witnessed. Best example, as we have seen, Dr. Ambedkar. So he was treated unequally, and that is why he faced that situation, and that forced him to fight for equality so that the next generation or in the coming days, people should not struggle for that. They may be well respected because they treat all persons with dignity and are therefore trusted and called upon to resolve issues in the community. Often, some of these people became more widely recognized, like Gandhiji or, as I told you, Ambedkar, because they have the support or represent a large number of people. So they are known. Why? Because they have wide support from the people and also represent large number of people who have united to address a particular issue on inequality. In India, there are several struggles in which people have come together to fight for issues that they believe are important. So many, you can say, the issues and wherein people have come forward to fight for inequality. Examples, you can say that BD workers, Then fish folk. Fish folk means fish. Folk means people. Fish folk. Then agricultural laborers, slum dwellers, and each group is struggling for justice in its own way. So these are all the different types of association wherein people form their own organization to fight for this equality or inequality. There are also many attempts to form cooperative or other collective way by which people can have more control over the resources. Now, one such incident or cooperative association is Tawa Matsya Sangh. Okay, now by the name itself you will come to know that what is the meaning of Matsya. Matsya is fish, isn't it? Tawa Matsya Sangh. Tawa is a name of a river. Okay, Tawa Matsya Sangh. Tawa river या lake जो भी है, yes, वहाँ पर Matsya Sangh. Tawa Matsya Sangh is a name. Let's come to the exact meaning, or I can say what it is, everything now. It's a federation of fish workers cooperatives, an organization fighting for the rights of the displaced forest dwellers of Satpura forest in Madhya Pradesh. So where it is this? This is in Madhya Pradesh. What it is? It is an association, or you can say federation of fish workers cooperative. And why it was formed? It was formed to fight for the rights of the displaced forest dwellers of Satpura forest. What do you mean by the displaced forest dwellers? Means the people, those who are living in the forest, they were asked to relocate to some other area forcefully. And that is why people are not happy, and people, they considered it as an inequality. The reason is there, that we will come to know later. And that is why they started going against this by forming an association or federation. Where it is? In Madhya Pradesh. Now, what is the reason that made the rise of Tawa Matsya Sangh? When dams were built or forest areas declared sanctuaries for animals, thousands of people are displaced. So two possibilities are there, wherein the relocation or forest dwellers, those who are entirely depending upon forest as their home, they have to relocate to some places for two reasons, either at the time of the construction of dam, or sometime when that particular forest area, when it is declared as the sanctuaries, wildlife sanctuaries for animals. So maybe the Gir forest. So up to 1 or 5 kilometer, or you can maybe the less than that, more than that, that area, their human population is entirely banned. Why? Because there should be a peaceful living for atmosphere for the animals. They can move freely without any fear and from the human side. And the other way, if we can say that, even people are like human beings are also very much afraid of the animals. So both the way, they have to live a peaceful life. And that's why people are asked to leave that place and to relocate to some other areas. Same thing is, well, at the time of the construction of dam also, when you are constructing a dam and thereby making it as a reservoir, at that time you have to, or I can say, so many villages will be maybe submerged. So pani ke andar submerge hota hai. तो उस टाइम में खतरा हो सकता है, अगर बहुत ज़्यादा पानी लेवल से ज़्यादा छोड़ दिया जाता है तो उस टाइम में उनको क्या कहा जाता है. तो और उस टाइम में नहीं, उसके पहले, एट द टाइम ऑफ द कंस्ट्रक्शन ओनली, पीपल आर आस्क्ड टू रिलोकेट टू सम डिफरेंट एरियाज. ओके, होल विलेजेस आर अपरूटेड. अपरूटेड मतलब अब ऊपर नीचे हो गया. And people are forced to go and build new homes, start new lives elsewhere. Most of these people are poor. Now poor people are entirely depending upon this forest as their home. Now they are homeless. In urban areas too, bastis in which people have lived are often uprooted. Abhi koi basti mein rehte hain, okay, that is not considered as a maybe ek basti mein, colony mein jaise rehte hain. और कल जाके वो कॉलोनी को बस्ती को किसी ले लेता है, पर्सन ले लेते हैं और वहाँ पर वो कंस्ट्रक्शन एक्टिविटी करके एंड ही वांटेड टू बिल्ड फ्लैट्स और ही वांटेड टू डू मॉल्स एंड ऑल एंड एट दैट टाइम पीपल हैव आस्क्ड टू मूव टू सम अदर एरिया इज़न्ट इट एंड द सेम थिंग इन अर्बन एरियाज ऑल्सो इट्स पॉसिबल Some of them are relocated to the areas outside the city. Okay, some people they went and they settled somewhere else. They work as well as their children's schooling is severely disrupted. Yes, of course. And because of the distance from the outskirts of the city to the location. Maybe now they have admitted in that particular area where it is very near to their forest and all. Now because of their, or you can say relocation, it has severely affected their children education too. The displacement of people and communities is the problem that has become quite widespread in our country. There are several organizations across the country fighting for the rights of the displaced. So there are many organizations. See, as I told you, the Tawa Matsya Sangh ke liye, to this is another one, Terry Dam ke liye. It's a textbook mein bhi diya hua hai. It's a just additional information related to this. A dam is built across river, a particular river, and that river name is Bhagirathi, where one can collect a lot of water. This form a reservoir as the water collects, it submerges most areas of land. This is because the wall of the dam across the river is high and the water spreads over a large area. This was the previous situation. Now what the government did? This is a photo of the submergence caused by Tehri Dam in Uttarakhand. And that's why, isme kya kiya? Jaise Tehri Dam, it's a dam, Uttarakhand on river Bhagirathi ko construct kiya. उसके चलते बहुत सारे विलेजेस जो है दैट सबमर्ज्ड मतलब पानी में डूब गया ओके एंड सम टोटली एंड ओल्ड चेरी डाउन एंड 100 विलेजेस वर सबमर्ज्ड एंड सम टोटली एंड सम पार्शियली कुछ तो गांव तो कम्प्लीटली गया और कुछ पार्शियली गया एंड नियरली 1 लाख पीपल वेर डिसप्लेस्ड सो इसके चलते दिस एडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग दिस चैप्टर दिस इज टेहरी डैम एज आई टोल्ड यू इट्स इन उत्तराखंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू तवा मत्स्य संघ इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड इन शॉर्ट एज TMS इट इज अ कोऑपरेटिव ऑफ ट्राइबल फिशरमैन डिस्प्लेस्ड बाय अ डैम प्रोजेक्ट डैम प्रोजेक्ट से जो डिस्प्लेस किए हुए ट्राइबल मैन का एक एसोसिएशन है ओके The Sangh is comprised of 38 primary cooperative of tribal persons whose villages were submerged following the construction of Tawa Dam on Tawa River, a tributary of River Narmada in 1975. But the government has given indication that the lease will be renewed once it expires on December 23. So this is a 38 primary members because all these 38 members they were relocated to some areas due to the construction of Tawa Dam. Now in 1994 the government gave the rights for fishing in the Tawa reservoir to the private contractor. Abhi isme गवर्नमेंट का क्या गलती है दैट इन द ईयर 1994 द गवर्नमेंट गिव द फिशिंग राइट टू प्राइवेट कॉन्ट्रैक्टर प्राइवेट कॉन्ट्रैक्टर दे कैन फिश दे कैन डू देयर फिशिंग एक्टिविटी इन द रिजर्वायर दीज कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स ड्रॉ द लोकल पीपल ड्रॉ मीन्स भगाना ओके ड्रॉ होना चाहिए ड्रॉ नहीं है ड्रॉ DROV the local people away and got cheap labor from outside. So local people को away करते हुए भगाते हुए जो दूसरे labor को मंगवाया है for they as they were available for cheap labor outsiders and they started their fishing activity in the reservoir who the private contractors. The contractors began to threaten the villagers who did not want to leave by bringing the hoodlums. Hoodlums means some type of, you can say that, gangster type, gundagiri dikhana. And the villagers stood united and decided that it was the time to set up an organization and to something to protect their right. So they said ki why when we are there, why to call an unknown person or labor from outside? And that is they thought that we should form an association. Hame kyu baga rahe? We are the original inhabitants. Why should we leave this place? And that is why they decided to form an organization. The newly formed, that is what? The newly formed Tawa Matsya Sangh with the 38 primary members, as I told you, organized. And they conducted rallies and there were chakka jam, matlab road jam hota hai, road traffic, demanding their right to continue fishing for their livelihood. They said, please allow us to continue our basic activity, our primary activity is fishing. Please allow us or give us the right to continue our fishing on Tawa River. In response to their protest, the government created a committee to assess the issue. So if there is any problem and all, the government immediately forms a committee and the committee, they are supposed to give a report. Ki kya hai karke. On the basis of that report, the government gives its decision. Committee recommended that fishing rights to be granted to the villagers for their livelihood. Yes, they should be allowed like that. The committee gave its report. And in 1996, the Madhya Pradesh government decided to give the people displaced by the Tawa Dam the fishing rights for their reservoir. So, 1994, it was given to private contractor. Then it was resulted in the formation of Tawa Matsya Sangh. And because of that, in 1996, the government gave the rights back to the original people, those who were displaced because of the dam. 5-year lease agreement. Lease agreement, matlab it's a type of rent only. Rent you need not to give a particular amount, you have to be deposited at the beginning only. So aise hota hai bade bade city mein, ghar ko rent pe nahi lete, lease pe dete for 3 years 5 years and all, and lump sum amount is deposited at the time of the agreement only, and the same amount will be given back to you at the end of the agreement. So in between, whatever the interest you are getting, that is called that rent. For that, बार बार every month deposit करने का नहीं है, 11 months का agreement का notice period भी नहीं है, so that is called lease. On January 2, 1997, people from 33 villages of Tawa started the new year with the first catch of fish को purpose उनको मिल गया fishing करने के लिए. With the TMS taking over, the fish workers were able to now increase their earnings substantially. Now their earnings started doubling. This was because they set up cooperative which would buy the catch from them at a fair price. Now what has happened? The Tawa Matsya Sangh is already formed. Now, jaise doodh ka dairy hai, to aapka extra doodh agar nahi sell out hota hai, jo barwad logon ka bhi, jo bhi hai, aur hum jaake wo doodh dairy mein dete hai. हाँ, उसके लिए भले वो एक दो रुपया कम देते हैं, बट हमारा वेस्ट तो नहीं जाएगा. एंड द सेम थिंग इज दैट यू हैव ऑलरेडी कॉट फिश एंड इफ इट इज़ नॉट सोल्ड आउट इन द मार्केट, डोंट वरी, नो वरीज, यू कैन गिव इट टू द तवा मत्स्य संघ वेर दे कीप दैट इन द आई कैन से कोल्ड स्टोरेजेस और इन बाय पुटिंग सम प्रिजर्वेटिव्स एंड ऑल, एंड फॉर दैट यू विल गेट मनी. ओके, आपको कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि आज मेरा फिश तो जो है खर्चा नहीं हुआ, मुझे ही खाना पड़ेगा, ऐसा कुछ नहीं. यू कैन गिव इट टू दैट एसोसिएशन. देन दे हैव नाउ बिगन टू अर्न 3 times more than what they used to get earlier. the TMS has also begun giving the fish worker loan for repair and buying the new net. That was the main, their main, what is called as the basic raw material required for it is, can say, unka jo investment hota hai net ke liye. And the Tawa Matsya Sangh also started giving them, or you can say, loan for either for purchasing or for repairing the nets. By managing to earn higher wage as well as preserving the fish in the reservoir, the TMS has shown that when people's organization get their rights to livelihood, they can be good managers. So, agar unko agar right milta hai, to then can be a good managers too. This is all with regard to the TMS, its formation, and finally it was successful. Now let's come to another one. That is, this one, last one also, they fight for their equality. Okay, we have to note that point. Now, last one, you can say, the Indian Constitution as a living document. The foundation of all movements for justice and the inspiration for all the poetry and songs on equality is the recognition that people are equal. The Indian Constitution recognizes the equality of all persons. Movements and struggles for equality in India continuously refer to the Indian Constitution to make their point about equality and justice for all. So every time, equality and justice, equality and justice. The fish workers in the Tawa Matsya Sangh hope that the provisions of the Constitution will become a reality through their participation in this movement. And that's why they they formed association and they protested, and finally they got back their rights. By constantly referring to the Constitution, they use it as a living document. Jo Constitution bolta hai, aise wo refer karte the. That's something that has real meaning in our lives. In a democracy, there are always communities and individuals trying to expand the idea of democracy and push for a greater recognition of equality on existing as well as new issues. Now, the issues of equality are central to democracy. Yes, democracy and equality. Equality agar nahi hota, inequality hota, to issues kya hai? These are, we read, that the privatization of health services in the country. Yes, we have seen that. Jinko chot lage the, kya unka naam tha? H se shuru hota hai. Hansari, aise kuch hai. And he got, accident, and the right time he was, even though he was admitted to the government hospital, and they denied by saying that they don't have the facility in our previous chapters, okay. That was that one, health services, they started demanding for health, private health services. The increasing control that business houses exert on the media, then that is the media and business house we have studied. The low value given to women and their work, whatever the household works done by these people made, they are not constructed as a valuable work, and the low earnings made by small farmers like Sapna. These issues substantially affect poor and the marginalized communities, and therefore concern the economic and social equality in the country. That's all about this chapter. We have come to an end of the slide. Thank you for being with me and supporting me. And hereby we are completing civics chapters 2. Please go through the chapter, read. And in the meantime, keep learning, keep studying, keep listening to your parents. Tata, bye-bye, and have a nice time. Take care of yourself. Yes, once again.